A new development has surfaced in the ongoing investigation surrounding the tragic murder of Audrey Fang, a 39-year-old Singaporean who was reported missing in Spain. Recent reports from Spanish news outlet La Verdad indicate that investigators have uncovered a significant piece of evidence, a note found in Audrey's iPad, shedding light on her intentions to nominate an undisclosed individual as her Central Provident Fund, CPF, beneficiary. The note, discovered by the Spanish Civil Guard during their investigation, outlines Audrey's decision to designate the individual as her CPF beneficiary. Describing this person as her trusted confidant, Audrey's note suggests a close relationship between herself and the nominee. In her message, Audrey explicitly states, I wish to clarify that my decision to nominate you for my CPF was made because you are my longtime friend and my trusted confidant. CPF nominations hold significant importance as they allow individuals to dictate the allocation of their CPF savings posthumously. The note, dated March 24, mere weeks before Audrey's body was found in Abanilla on April 10, also expressed gratitude to the unnamed recipient for previously lending her a substantial sum of money, $50,000, $68,000. Suspicions raised by Audrey's brother. However, Audrey's brother has cast doubt on the authenticity of the note. Upon reviewing it, he expressed skepticism, suggesting that it did not align with his sister's usual manner of communication. Key points of contention include the use of the greeting Heya, which is more commonly associated with fluent English speakers. Audrey primarily communicated in Mandarin, and her proficiency in English was limited. Furthermore, the note refers to USD instead of SGD, which raises further questions about its legitimacy. Moreover, recent revelations have unveiled that Mitchell Ong, the primary suspect in Audrey's murder, was listed as her agent in two insurance policies purchased back in 2015. Ong, operating under various aliases including Mitch Ong and Ong Chong Yi, had a presence on a now-defunct website. Spanish authorities have also informed Audrey's family about attempts to make changes to her CPF account in March, just before her trip to Spain. These developments add layers of complexity to an already convoluted case. Audrey Fang's funeral was held at Mandai Crematorium on Monday, April 29, marking a somber end to her life. However, investigations into her untimely demise continue as authorities work tirelessly to unravel the mysteries surrounding her death. As the case progresses, we urge viewers to stay tuned for further updates and developments. Your comments, likes, shares, and subscriptions are greatly appreciated as we endeavor to bring you the latest news and insights on this evolving story. 在新加坡 39岁女性 Audrey Fang 失踪并被确认在西班牙遇害的调查中，最新的发展浮出水面。 据西班牙新闻网站 La Verdad 报道，调查人员在他的 iPad 中发现了一张备忘录，揭示了他将某个未知个体提名为他的中央公积金 CPF 受益人的意图。备忘录揭示，西班牙国民警卫队在调查过程中发现了 Audrey Fang iPad 中的一张备忘录，其中概述了 Audrey 决定将此人指定为他的 CPF 受益人的决定。在备忘录中 ，Audrey 将此人描述为他的知心朋友。在他的信息中， Audrey 明确表示，我想澄清，我决定提名你为我的 CPF 受益人，是因为你是我的长期朋友和我值得信赖的知心朋友。CPF 的提名对于个人来说具有重要意义，因为他们允许个人在过世后分配他们的 CPF 储蓄。备忘录日期为3月24日，距离 Audrey 的尸体于4月10日在 Abanilla 被发现不到3周，还表达了对未知接收者之前借给他大笔资金，美元5万。 新元68000的感激之情。然而 ，Audrey 的兄弟对备忘录的真实性提出了质疑。在审查后，他表示怀疑，表示这与他姐姐平时的交流方式不符。争议的焦点包括使用的问候语 “Hey”， 这更常见于流利的英语使用者。Audrey 主要使用普通话进行交流，他的英语水平有限。此外，备忘录提到美元而不是新加坡元，这进一步引发了关于其合法性的疑问。此外， 最近的调查发现 ，Mitchell Ong, Audrey Fang 被害案的主要嫌疑人，被列为他在2015年购买的2项保险政策的代理人。Ong 在一个现已关闭的网站上使用了各种化名，包括 Mitch Ong 和 Ong Chong。西班牙当局还告知 Audrey 的家人，在3月他前往西班牙之前，有人试图更改他的 CPF 账户。这些发展为本已错综复杂的案件增添了更多复杂性。 Audrey Fang 的葬礼于4月29日星期一在 Mandai 火葬场举行，为他的生命画上了沉重的句号。然而，对他突然死亡的调查仍在继续， 当局正在不懈努力解开围绕他死亡的谜团。随着案件的进展，我们敦促观众继续关注进一步的更新和发展。请留下您的评论、点赞、分享和订阅，我们将竭尽所能，为您带来这一不断发展的故事的最新消息和见解。